Hey all, welcome to my YouTube class. I'm Manjeet Rawat, your online instructor. If you guys are Mac users, so now it's time to upgrade your existing operating system to latest version of Mac operating system. I'm talking about Sequoia 15.1. I'm giving you multiple reasons to upgrade your existing operating system to the latest. In this video, the agenda of this class, I'm going to guide you each and every steps, like how to upgrade the operating system, and what are the prerequisites in the sense, like if you are using MacBook Air or if you are using MacBook Air M1, M2, M3. So which types of machine, which types of processor can support this particular version? Also, we'll discuss about the minimum hard disk required to upgrade the Sequoia 15.1. Apart from this, I'll also give you the complete information about the latest features that are added by Apple. So as you aware guys, recently Apple launched a latest version of mobile phone. I'm talking about the 16 and 16 Pro, like something multiple model of 16 available in the market. And they introduced, like, they are planning to add Apple intelligence with their mobile phones. But unfortunately, I don't think we are able to find the option. Right now, we don't have any access related to the Apple intelligence in our mobile phone. But if we talk about the Sequoia 15.1, they added free of cost Apple intelligence that will definitely help you to enhance the productivity. With the help of Apple intelligence, you can create your own image. You can edit your own image without using any third party software. Apart from the image, it will give us an option to mirror your Apple device. It may be iPad, it may be iPhone. You can directly mirror with your Mac machine. Although the same options are available with the old version of Apple operating system. But what's new in Sequoia 15.1? In Sequoia 15.1, we are definitely able to mirror the Apple device with, like, Apple phone, iPhone or iPad with your laptop. Apart from the mirroring, you are able to drag and drop the application. You can drag and drop the files. Earlier, we are using maybe Bluetooth, maybe AirDrop, maybe by using the USB, we are able to transfer the data. But nowadays, if the both devices are connected with the same network, same Wi-Fi, you just need to mirror your mobile phone to the Apple, not only the Apple, Sequoia 15.1, and you can easily drag and drop the data from Apple laptop to mobile phone and mobile phone to laptop, vice versa. This is the one feature. This is the included feature in our Sequoia 15.1. Apart from this, we can manage our battery health as well, right? So we are able to, like, as a get a more kind of a backup in our existing machine. And second important part, we are able to use, we are using the notepad kind of things, text activity we can manage with our Apple machine. But with the help of latest version of Sequoia operating system, we can perform the task with AI. Apart from the texting part, you can also manage your image related activity. You can remove the background from any image. Apart from removing the background, you can also remove the particles or remove the things from your photographs. So I'll give you the complete information. I'll give you the practical information about how we can utilize the latest feature of Sequoia 15.1. So that's why I'm moving myself to the screen and give you the proper information about how to upgrade our existing operating system to the latest version of a Mac operating system. I hope you guys are able to see my screen. So first of all, let me help you to understand about the configuration. I'm talking about the machine that I'm using. Go to the Apple icon and click on the About Mac. So the configuration of my laptop is Apple MacBook Air with M1 chip, 8GB of RAM, and the current operating system that I'm using, it is Sonomo 14.5, and I'm going to convert this operating system to the Sequoia 15.1. Apart from this, if we talk about the available space, so free hard disk space, how much space required to update this operating system? So let me help you to understand. 7.5 GB minimum hard disk must be available in free, like free minimum free 7.5 free hard disk available in your system, then you are able to proceed and upgrade your operating system. So what you need to do, I'm just going to update it. Just need to click on general tab, and in the general tab, you just need to click on software updates, and in the software update, 15.1, 6.75 GB hard disk required to upgrade, to proceed to upgrade your operating system. Make sure before proceed to upgrade your operating system, make sure your system must be with minimum 60% of battery backup, right? Because it will take time. It required up to 25 to 30 minutes required to give you the complete features of Sequoia 15.1. So I'm going to proceed because we have enough time. Ideal time is 20 minutes, but I'm going to proceed to, like, as it will take up to 30 minutes, right? Click on upgrade and everything is okay. We have enough space. Agree. And provide password of your base machine. So let me provide the password of my system. Downloading is started. It will definitely take time. So once we download the 6.5 GB of data, then we can proceed for the upgrade. Once we're ready with the Sequoia 15.1, definitely we'll give you the another video, and that video will give you 25 important and unique features of Sequoia 15.1. So stay tuned with TeachMeCloud. Definitely will give you the practical information about the latest version of Mac operating system. So for now we have to wait because it will take half an hour. So I'll definitely create another video based on latest version of Apple operating system and definitely share with you that you can improve your knowledge. Okay everyone, so please do subscribe here on TeachMeCloud YouTube channel. We'll connect soon with another part where we can discuss about the Sequoia 15.1, the features of Sequoia 15.1. Take care guys, bye bye, and do subscribe.